Hi everyone, in this video we move on to the network device logs. So this is the next portion of this module, which is going to focus on the analysis of network security device logs. We will go through different types of logs and their processing in the log management center. Network device logs are information generated during operation of any network device. Logs help network administrators to ascertain running status of a service and operating status of a module. The generation, collection, and resolution of logs consume system resources and may impact performance. Therefore, system efficiency will increase if the collected content and the output direction of logs are customized and filtered. Huawei Firewall can generate different types of logs. For example, we can have session logs, we can have packet loss logs, we can have service logs, and we can have system logs. Session logs are the logs that are generated whenever the firewall sets up a session. Administrator can enable firewall to generate session logs at session creation, session termination, or at periodic intervals. Similarly, packet loss logs are generated when the firewall discards a packet. This log also contains the packet discarding cause. Service logs include threat, content, policy matching, mail filtering, URL filtering, and audit logs. System logs contain operating information of functional modules of the firewall. If we look at the log output mechanisms, we will see that, as in the last slide we discussed, that there are different types of logs generated by a firewall. Output mechanism of different types of these logs on the firewall are different. So if we first look at the session packet loss and port pre-allocation logs, these three types of logs are directly generated by the firewall onto the log server through independent channels. These logs are then available for the administrator for viewing and further analysis. Port pre-allocation log, by the way, is an enhanced NAT-based technology in which USC pre-allocates port resources for users. Port resources include public IP address and related port range. Port pre-allocation logs are generated after pre-allocation function is enabled. It cannot be generated otherwise. Service logs is another type of log, as we studied in the previous slide. Firewall has multiple output paths for service logs. First output path is to directly generate service logs on the log server through independent channels, just like the other types of logs. Second output path is to generate logs in the memory database, which processes them using the log query module. Reports and corresponding logs are then displayed on the web user interface. Then the third option is to generate these logs in buffers. Logs are extracted and displayed on web user interface panel. Fourth and the final option for service logs is for the output path is to generate service logs through the information center. Likewise, if you look at the system logs are generated by the firewall through the information center. An information center is the hub for system software module. It can generate logs onto the log server or the log buffer, console, terminal, or in the form of log files. There are two means for administrators to view these logs. First is to use the log server, and the second one is to view it on the firewall itself. And as we know that generating these logs can be a pivotal component of the logging system, so we need a very robust or a very reliable log server. To ensure this reliability, we should have multiple log servers. We can configure them on the firewall so that the firewall is sending those logs to different servers, to different log servers, either on the basis of for the purpose of geographical redundancy, or simply within the same data center on two separate physical machines. USG supports multiple log formats like binary, syslog, netflow, and data flow. If you want to view system logs, these logs can include system alarms, user login or logout details, system operations and blacklists. By viewing the system logs, the administrator can obtain operating system and hardware related events. And these logs facilitate fault locating and analysis during troubleshooting. Various fields of system logs are shown on the slide. These include security level, log type, timestamp, log source, and description as examples. Time field indicates the time once a system log is generated. Log type, for example, includes the alarm, login, operation, and blacklist logs. Logs can also be exported to a file in multiple formats for the future reference and offline analysis. We partially discussed this in the previous slide as well. Similarly, if you want to view the service logs, as we discussed already, include threat logs, content logs, policy matching logs, mail filtering logs, URL filtering, and audit logs. USC can generate service logs onto the web user interface or onto log server or through the information center. By viewing service logs, administrators can obtain service running status and network status. Important fields of service logs are given here, which include the security level and the log type. As you know that there are service logs can be of different types. So if we look at the service logs that relate to the content, or if you look at the content logs, then just a recap, a firewall is deployed between the internet and the network to be protected. And content logs are generated when the traffic matches file blocking rules in file blocking or data filtering rules defined in the data filtering policy. In this way, application behavior is also controlled. Various fields of content log are flashed, like as shown in the slide. Type, file name, file type, source and destination addresses, application, action, security policy, and associated profiles. So these are the informations which you can see for each of the content logs that is generated by the firewall. Application field, for example, indicates the application of the traffic that has matched a criteria, and action represents the response configured in the file blocking, data filtering, or application behavior control rules. The other type of service log that we saw were the user activity logs. User activity logs are generated when any user logs in, logs out, changes the password, freezes, or unfreezes. By viewing user activity logs, administrator can check users' online records such as login time, online duration, freeze duration, login IP address, and current user activities. These logs help to identify abnormal user login. Various fields of activity logs are flashed on the screen in front of you. For example, the user field indicates the username, and the type field indicates the type of a user activity, such as successful or failed login attempts. The next type of service logs that we can view are the policy matching logs. As we know that firewall is deployed between untrusted networks like internet and the network or networks to be protected, we define security policies on firewall. Traffic passing through a firewall has to match a set of configured policies, and a deny or permit decision is taken accordingly. Policy matching logs are another type of service logs which are generated when the traffic matches configured security policies. By viewing these logs, administrators can determine whether the security policies are configured correctly and are meeting the requirements. These logs can also be used to locate faults during troubleshooting. Format of policy matching logs is shown on this slide right in front of you. Security zone indicates the security zone from which traffic is generated. Destination zone indicates the security zone to which traffic is destined, and action represents the response configured if any traffic flow matches a certain security policy. Then we look at the mail filtering logs. This is another type of service logs. Mail filtering logs are generated when traffic meets certain triggering requirements. We can set triggering criteria like sender or receiver email address, email subject, attachment name, maximum number of email attachments, etc. you can see on your screen or on the slide the format of the mail filtering log. Here as well, if you look at some of the fields, the type field points out to the type of mail filtering logs, including blacklist logs and anonymous mail logs. Filtering type field indicates the type of logs to be filtered, such as the blacklist, local whitelist, mail address, number of attachments, attachment size, and anonymous mails. And finally, mail protocol indicates which mail protocol is being used, for example, SMTP, POP3, and IMAP. And then the final type of service logs are the audit logs. Audit is a very important process of maintaining strong control over network operations. One type of service logs generated by Huawei Firewall is the audit logs, as is being shown on the slide. These types of logs are generated when the communication traffic matches rules defined in the audit profile. By viewing audit logs, administrators can obtain users' FTP behavior, HTTP behavior, email sending and receiving behavior, IM behavior, and keyword searching behavior. Here you can see the format of audit logs or the different fields or different types of information that you see. So, for example, type field specifies the type of audit log, and application field indicates the application of the traffic whose log has been generated. So these were the different types of system and service logs. In the next video, we are going to look at the log event management center. So let's see you in the next video. And till then, thank you.